Hallo Vion en welkom ik in de Planet Coaster. Is het Planet Coaster? Yes, Planet Coaster. En we're in de World's Fair Park. What are we doing today? Well, what are we doing today? We're doing the interior scenes of the rides. And there's a couple. There is the transport ride. The transport ride, I should say, the roller coaster. And the boat ride. Those are the two important ones. And then do we have any more interior stuff? Maybe like a hallway or something. Anyway, that's what we will be doing today. And we've first got some like small things that we're adding into the park, such as this tower. I think it's like a mooring tower. Normally there's like a staircase as well, but like I thought maybe like a pointy thing will work out better, I should say, to fit better in the area with the airship. So yeah, and then like a little wind catcher there, so for the extra theming and feels, to fill the park up a bit, because we have a lot of open spaces, of open plazas, and that does look cool, but I want some more things to look at. Now, we're inside the interior of the factory building, the warehouse, what it is, and I have a name reveal. I asked like a last time, or like two times ago, what would be a cool name for the roller coaster, and there were a couple of cool ones. Someone suggested like a Latin name, Volaris or something, which I thought was cool. But another one, he said aerial transport. I thought, oh, that's very fitting. So why not go with that? So yeah, aerial transport. That's the name of the roller coaster. Because it is a delivery system by rail in the air, so we... What a descriptive name. Amazing. Anyway, yeah, I needed to clean up this interior a bit, because I didn't look at it at all while constructing the outside. And I patched up the walls, and now I'm placing beams. A lot of beam everywhere. And just to make it seem a bit pretty, you know, because we can't ignore the interiors. And at this time, we're kind of running short on time. Only 2 days left for the deadline of the contest. So this isn't my best work, but I'm content with it. You know, it did turn out nice enough to satisfy me. That's mostly due to the help of Team TK, and especially the Team TK by Artificial Artist, who made these beams on the walls and a lot of other things I'm using everywhere. Very grateful for that, especially for this build. So yeah, big shout out to Artificial Artist on the workshop. Go check him or her out. Really do appreciate all of it. And then I placed some safety fences here, just to... divide the room up a bit. You don't want like this big open hall that looks too big, and you need some supporting structures in there. Placing some more lamps, of course, and then, of course, it is a warehouse. What do you have in warehouses? Boxes, and lots of boxes, and newspapers. Now, not no newspapers, but here they do. Planet Coaster loves their newspapers. Like, if I would have really gotten the time to really think about this interior, I would have probably done something else. But boxes work always, you know? And then I put some rope things down so it looks like it's like tied down. Why not? It does its job. And some barrels. Wow. Barrels everywhere. Wow. Some stuff to... You know, it's just clutter, you know? Theming. Very basic theming. And in my next projects, I probably will take a bit more time to think about what we want in this, in the parks that are upcoming, to really make it our own, and without any deadline for a contest. Even though I really like doing contests, but sometimes you just gotta take your own time, you know, No schedule, just ride that wave. Yes, okay. And there's a door inside here, because there's a door outside as well. And when you want to have a door inside, you also have the door outside. Otherwise, it doesn't work. That's the concept of a door, right? More boxes here. And slowly starting to come together. I am also going to replace those floors here, because the concrete slabs, I don't know why I went with those initially. Maybe because factories have like a concrete floor, I don't know, not in this time. So I went with a more like cobblestone-y texture later on, which I'm really happy with. Probably also by Artificial Artist, not sure though. And then some posters here, because it's a warehouse and a guest walk through it. It's a World's Fair, so you want to advertise. Advertise everywhere. It is America after all, probably. And then these lights, Team TK lampshades with the lanterns inside, turned out to be a good fit for this hallway. And some white lighting on the walls to have a little bit of color variation. And I think I put blue lights that illuminate the domey structure on top. I really like blue lights, and maybe that works because we're used to seeing like the moonlight and the street lights down at the bottom. That are orange and blue and blah de blah de blah. Here I'm replacing the floor. Wow, such interesting stuff. Okay, I think that's the dead interior done. See, pretty basic, but it looks nice nonetheless. But yeah, nothing revolutionary on that front. Then just finishing this little side room, just so it looks a bit more tidy. We can't have an ugly room, messing up the place. More boxes. A lot of boxes, more newspapers. Oh, I wonder how many days worth of newspapers that is, man. Like, has anyone ever read those? I don't know. I wonder what's in them. And then I just place some iron stuff here and there, like a little fence and more fence on top of the fence. Fenception. And that's that complete. Oh, we're luckily outside again. Yeah, I added more light bulbs because we have to remind you, we have a 75,000 piece limit, and at this point I was at like 37,000 or 40,000, so I was like, okay, we have the piece margin, let's just place a lot of light bulbs to lighten up the place a bit, huh? Yeah, and then I remember to do the fencing inside as well. Also, I redid that construction thing actually, that gas tower, because yeah, the path wasn't lining up correctly, so that's completely redone as well. It's a bit wider now. Oh yeah, new bridges, because I wasn't happy with the natural heap of rocks that was really messy and didn't make sense. So yeah, we're making a man-made bridge now, and I'm really happy with this. I'm so glad I did this. It's really simple, but it does its job, like, and especially with those ruined pieces. See, it just works. It's a bridge now. Bam. And then on the other side, of course, the same thing. Another bridge, and then I extended it a bit to make it a bit more wheelchair accessible. Otherwise, it would have been quite a steep hill to climb with like a wheelchair. Yeah, some more details and covering it up with the path texture as we are used to by now. Probably not going to use that cobblestone for a while. Used it so much here. And then inside is a very, very narrow tunnel. But you know, it's... maybe I could have done something else, but like this was like a day before the deadline. So you know how it is. Boom, boom, boom. Just make something that looks pleasing to the eye. And that shall be it. I used this cracked brick texture that I found on the workshop. A lot in this build. Yeah, just to have something different than the classic brick walls or the ruined pieces, you know. Yeah, I'm a big fan of that. Then some terrain work here. It's a bit iffy how it works exactly. Also, I'm gonna construct backstage stuff next episode. You know, I'll talk about it then, you know. But yeah, some terrain stuff here. And then more of that cobblestone-y texture on the floor. And then I'm placing some walls here and there. Not going to show you everything, but you can kind of see how I did that to just have some extra rooms in there and to clean it up a bit, because it was one big mess here. Of course, if you only work on the front facade and then you look at the interior and it's really ugly. But we finished that up nicely. Then some rocky rocks here, some stone walls. I thought, oh, it could be cool to have like a cavern adjacent to this little station building. And so I'm using these Team Decay rocks here that I use way too much. But oh well, it works, does the job. Now, I will try to use those a bit less in the future, if I can, you know. I'm noticing that I'm falling into like a pattern of using a lot of the same items, and that's like a signal to me that I should like take my time a bit more and really explore. So actually after this is one more contest going on, actually two. That's the Planet X one, where I'm building a really cool project underwater, and another one for Planet Zoo and the Zoofluencers Discord, where I'm building a water park. So that's really interesting, so expect that soon on the channel as well. The interior of this I'm not showing you a lot. It's basically the same concept as the interior for the roller coaster, just with more water stuff. So I put actually waterfalls in here to have that like tropical vibe, and just imagine smelling, it smells like Pirates of the Caribbean in here, like the ride. So that's really cozy and nice, and like a lot of good fumes for your lungs. And of course more boxes, because we don't have enough boxes in this side of the park. Sadly some creativity did come at a cost. No wait. Some time came at no yeah some efficiency came at the cost of creativity in the end, but yeah, yet again it I think it holds up fine. Will it win the contest? I don't know at the point of the recording. I don't know. There's a lot of super good competition out there with amazing creation, so I'm curious to see how it will go. Anyway, that's the video. I hope you liked it, subscribe and stuff, and become a member if you want early access to this video, often like a week, and get other special perks, and that was it. Bye!